Once you have data inside of your computer, it's very common to have to find ways to get that data out of your computer. And one common way is to print it. If you are in a retail environment, you may have these smaller receipt printers next to your point of sale system, or perhaps you're in a home or a home office and you have these smaller printers that are able to produce color output and even be able to do things like scan and copy things as well. If you're in a very large environment, the printers may be very big. They may have multiple capabilities. You may be able to control them over an Ethernet connection across the network and be able to produce some very advanced documents. A lot of the features that we use in our computers these days is related to audio, whether we're listening to podcasts or perhaps playing music from a streaming music service. And if we wanted to hear that, we would need some type of speaker. Anything on a left-right speaker, we might even want to add a subwoofer to the mix. But you can even get very advanced speaker systems for your computers and your laptops these days that can provide you with a lot of different options to hear the audio coming out of your computer. And of course, one of the most common PC output devices are the monitors that we use. Us human beings need to be able to see what the operating system is telling us and then be able to monitor what we are providing as input back into the computer system. These days, our display devices are very thin. We're carrying them around on our mobile devices, they're on our desktops, and they're even on the tablet PCs that we use these days. And it provides us with an easy way to see exactly what's happening in our operating system and be able to control the computers that we're using.